So if you were gifted the power of invisibility, how would you use it? Would you use it for good things, or you might for creating mischief, for creating problems for others? How? Yeah, what? Oh my God, we'll think about that only, right? We can think of that only. Question papers, that's it. Nothing beyond that. Anything else? Yeah, what else? So when you're in school, you'll think about question papers. But supposing, right, later on in life, if you get this power, how would you use that? If you had to use it for something good, how would you use it? How would you use it if you want to use this power of invisibility? Yeah, of course. Yes. You can track people who are there. You can track criminals, isn't it? So you can help over there. Okay, let me see. I am getting a lot of answers. Okay, yeah, you would help others and, right, you would punish bad people. Someone is saying I would tease people. Okay, huh? Right, yes, so Marie Curie also, right? So when we talk about, you know, scientists here, yes, let us not forget Madame Curie, right? So we have here, right, so when like women have also contributed immensely in the field of science, right? But why here, when we're talking about any power that science gives you, your discovery that you made, it is here when we have power. With power comes responsibility. If you are able to use that responsibility or use that power in a good way, that will make you a good person. If you misuse your power, it will make you a bad person, isn't it? Right? So when we are given this power here, like, yes. So when you read about superheroes and everything, so they all have some kind of special power? You watch your superheroes, right? And we like them because they're good, right? So when they are bad, of course, we wonder why they're behaving like that. We expect them to be good. We expect them to use their powers for the welfare of humanity, isn't it, right? So immediately a person who does not do that is considered as a villain or considered as a bad person, right? So it is here once again, what happens is that, yes, so when you are given that, yes, please separate a little bit, leave a bench in between. So when we are given those powers, we have to use them wisely and judiciously. As I told you, Footprints Without Feet, and it's an extract from the book, as you said, The Invisible Man by H.G. Wells, right? And here it is about this scientist, a very brilliant scientist. He could have got so much of respect. He could have got so much of recognition if he had used his power in a wise way. But he wanted to become very powerful. He wanted to control everyone. And he used this power of invisibility in a wrong way. And it so ended that imagine that such a scientist, a brilliant scientist, he ended up being chased like a criminal. And people wanted to catch him and they wanted him out of the way because he was becoming dangerous, right? So here what has happened, it is Griffin, he has discovered the power of invisibility, right? And first of all, he does a lot of experiments, you know, like he does this experiment on a cat, he makes a cat invisible, he does it on wool, right? No, not on the rat, on the cat only he does. Right, and then of course he tries it on himself. So when he makes himself invisible, he does not realize that there are going to be problems. If I am becoming invisible, I will remain a human being. I won't change into something else. So what if a god that he's going to feel cold, he's going to feel hungry, he need home, he need shelter, right? So these things he did not anticipate, these things he did not think about. And so when he became invisible, these things started creating a problem for him. So we're talking about London here, the winter months, how cold it can be. Snowing and raining. And right, he was invisible as long as he was not wearing these layers of clothes. So when he wore the clothes, he became, because the clothes would take shape, was visible. And it was face also. Face was, they seemed that it was this big hole, his mouth. And so he, like, of course, it was a little scary, you know, like, yeah. And if people looked carefully, they might even notice, like, yeah, the food there in his body. Right? And now what happened was that, yes, yeah, so he was out there in the winter months. It's snowing, it's raining, it's very bad weather. And as he's walking, he is leaving behind footprints. There are footprints, there are no feet. This is where we get the title of the chapter. So whose footprints are they? The footprints of the scientist, right? So we talk about the scientist, that is Griffin, okay? And before this chapter, he has discovered this formula of invisibility, right? And now he is there trying to use his powers. And he does use it in a bad way. He has caused a lot of harm, but before he has left his place, he's burnt down the place where he lived, right? So that there will be no evidence that he was there. And he did not want anybody to find about his secret of invisibility, right? And he did not want anybody else to take credit for that. Clear? So no matter how the person, intelligent that person might be, how powerful that person might be, how wealthy that person might be. But once again, if he does not use his power and strength for good qualities, it will be zero. Right? So we, even if that person is there, like, we will not like that person if he is not doing anything good for the people. Okay? So let's take a look at the chapter here. Yes. So how did the invisible man first become visible? Why was he wandering the streets? Right? So we are here, yes, reading about this. The two boys started in surprise at the fresh, muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. The two boys there, like, they were walking and they were very surprised. They saw this imprints. Imprints is impression. Right? Pair of bare feet. Who's going to walk around bare feet in the cold London winter? No one. So they're wondering, what was a barefooted man doing on the steps of a house in the middle of London? And where was the man? They could not see the man. They could only see the footprints. Why couldn't they see the man? Because he was invisible. Yes. As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. A fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. So as they were looking at those footprints, something very strange happened. Another pair of footprints came, right? Further footprints followed, one after another, descending the steps and progressing down the street. And these boys are very curious, where are these footprints coming from? The boys followed, fascinated, until the muddy impressions became fainter and fainter and at last disappeared altogether. Right? So then they were no longer visible, the footprints, and the boys, otherwise they followed him. They might have caught the man there, right? His secret would have been out if the boys had followed him more. The explanation of the mystery was really simple enough. The bewildered boys had been following a scientist who had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. Can invisibility be called as being transparent? What is transparent? Something that light passes through? Yes. Okay. So can we see things that are transparent? Yes, glass, right? Okay. But if we have this huge piece of glass over there, of course, we are able to find out if it is there, fit somewhere. But if it is just kept over there, what if we hit into it? You might? Yes. So transparent here, like, of course, he's saying that person had made himself transparent. As a result, what had he become? He had become invisible, right? And do you know there are so many living organisms there at some stage or the other, they are transparent. Jellyfish, very good. Right, so there are many sea animals there, many aquatic animals. So yeah, so they are there transparent. Okay, right? Griffin, the scientist, had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. Why would someone want to make the human body invisible? Why would he want to make it transparent? Just to show that, yes, just like other animals, we can also become transparent, right? I can use a certain formula, right? And of course, that means it's so hardworking and intelligent enough to have the patience to keep on working and working. Patience is one quality of a scientist. Yes, the experiments are going to fail. Yeah, the experiments are going to fail. They'll have to start again. Right? And of course, here, yes, that, you know, like patience there, and they have to keep on investigating and finding more, you know, maybe better ideas, and you have to think about where that calculation went wrong, where everything went wrong. So, you know, like when we see all these great inventions around us, we also need to admire the minds of the great people behind it. There are things that we take for granted, but there is a great mind behind all of that, isn't it? Yes? Hardik, wear your mask. Nice, good, right? Griffin, the scientist, had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. Finally, he swallowed certain rare drugs and his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass, though it also remained as solid as glass. So he's become transparent or he's become invisible. It is not that, yeah, you can just even pass your hand through, like, right? He is still as solid, right? So he has that weight and mass, whatever you say, right? So he has that shape when he puts on clothes. Otherwise, without it, he is transparent. He is invisible, okay? Right? Brilliant scientist though he was, Griffin was rather a lawless person. Lawless. He did not obey the law. He had broken many laws. Right? So there is something we don't like about him. He's broken the law. Okay? His landlord disliked him and tried to eject him, tried to remove him, send him his away. Yeah, air is transparent. Very good, Bhavna. Very nice. Very nice. So, brilliant scientist, his landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. In revenge, Griffin set fire to the house. An angry scientist. A law-breaking scientist. Right? That means he's a very... Is he someone very useful, or is he dangerous then? Dangerous. So, a scientist who does not bother about breaking the law, a scientist who does not bother about putting a house on fire, right, to save himself, so that people will not know about his invisibility, right? So he's put the landlord got angry and he put the house on fire. Fine, don't tell anybody about me. To get away without being seen, he had to remove his clothes. The first thing he had to do. Thus, it was that he became a homeless wanderer. So that's how he ended up without a home, because he had set fire. Right now he is without clothes, because if he wears clothes, he would be visible. Without money, right? Where can he work when he's invisible? Can he get a job being invisible? No. And of course, he's quite invisible. And he did that. He's going to do that. Okay. Yeah. Formulae ko sahi kar sakta tha, but he did not want to do that. He had a plan that I want to create terror and fear in the minds of the people. I want to become powerful. Some people think that becoming powerful is creating fear. Yeah? And he was one of them. He could have used it for better purposes, right? Invisibility. He could have, become very popular and very famous because of his discovery, and it could have been used for better purposes also. But no, he wanted power, right? So that's why. it was that he became a homeless wanderer without clothes, without money, and quite invisible until he happened to step in some mud and left footprints as he walked. So everything was going on fine till he stepped in the mud. And then he started leaving footprints. He escaped easy enough from the boys who followed his footprints in London. So he ran away, he went and hid so that the boys could not find him. The boys who were following him, right? But his adventures were by no means over. He had chosen a bad time of the year to wander about London without clothes. It was midwinter, very cold. The air was bitterly cold and he could not do without clothes. Instead of walking about the streets, he decided to slip into a big London store for warmth. So no one can see him coming and going. So what did he decide to do? He went inside a big store and the store would be warm. He could spend time over there. No one would see him even, isn't it? Right. So closing time arrived, and as soon as the doors were shut, Griffin was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing and feeding himself with regard to expense. The store was shut, closing time. Who was there? No one. Griffin was there, and everything was there around him. It was a big store. So there was clothes also, there was food also. So he wore clothes and he ate, right? Without bothering about being caught, because there was no one there to catch him. He broke open boxes and wrappers and filled himself out with warm clothes. He opened the boxes, he found clothes, and he wore them to keep himself warm. Soon, with shoes, an overcoat, and a wide-brimmed hat, he became a fully dressed and visible person. So how did he become visible? By wearing clothes. Where did he get the clothes from? The store. Did he pay for them? What did he do? He stole them. He's broken another law. Yes? Right? Okay, so he's going hiding in that shop and he's taking out the clothes. He's wearing them. Food also he's having. And now he's looking like a proper person. Okay? So he became in the kitchen of the restaurant. He found cold meat and coffee. And he followed up the meal with sweets and wine taken from the grocery store. Finally, he settled down to sleep on a pile of quilts. He's having a good time. Yes, he's enjoying himself over there in the store, eating and wearing clothes and relaxing without any tension of anybody catching him, right? If only Griffin had managed to wake up in good time, all might have been well. Good time, the right time, proper time. Nothing would have gone wrong. As it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arriving next morning. He got late and the assistants were coming to work, right? And they're opening the shop. As it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arriving. When he saw a couple of them approaching, he panicked and began to run. So he got scared and started running. They naturally gave chase. Who was this person there in their store alone at night? In the end, he was able to escape only by quickly taking off his newly found clothes to save himself from being caught. So one by one, he started removing all the clothes that he had stolen. So once more, he found himself invisible, but naked in the chill January air. Not a nice thing to happen. So he didn't find clothes. Why couldn't he keep them? Because he fell asleep in the store. Yes. And of course, here, what else was there? The people came, the shop people. This time, he decided to try the stock of a theatrical company in the hope of finding not only clothes, but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulders. So maybe this part, you know, this gap was showing, right? Shivering with cold, he hurried to Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So where did he go? Drury Lane. What is Drury Lane? Where all the costumes for the theater world is available, right? So theater world, all the artists, they require the costumes, and so that place is famous for that. He soon found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later wearing bandages around his forehead. So he was able to find all the things that he needed because it was a costume shop. Look at your book. We're on the next page. Right? So he was there. He was able to find even bandages to wrap around his face. So he's able to find everything from that theatrical shop, right? The costume shop. What else was he wearing? Bandages around his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers. So he's put on these whiskers also, and a large hat. So he's completely covered himself. Right? To escape without being seen, he callously attacked the shopkeeper from behind, after which he robbed him of all the money he could find. How many crimes did he commit? So he stole also, right? Not only the clothes, but he stole the money and he hit the shopkeeper. I mean, like, of course, the shopkeeper became injured and lying unconscious. Okay, right. So let us here just come back to the first page and see these questions. How did the invisible man first become visible? Invisible man become visible, yes, when he wore the clothes in the store, right? So yes, the clothes, they gave him shape and he was, you know, like, yeah, visible once again. Then now, why was he wandering the streets? To tease people, no. Why was he wandering the streets? Because what had he done to his home where he lived? He had burnt it down. There was no place where he could live. He had ran away from there. Yes, yeah, so he was not having clothes. He did not have money. And he was roaming around on the streets. Okay. Now, do you think the scientist has become a criminal rather than a respectable person, right? So once again here, it is, you know, one thing, it is there. Someone can use it, the same power. If used in a good purpose, it would have made him a better person. But he did not want to do that. He wanted to use it in a bad way, right? He wanted to be powerful and he ended up hurting people. He ended up committing crimes. And now he is running away. Because, yes, he has done a lot of wrong things, okay, right? So once again, as I say here, when we talk about, being a scientist, right? Have you heard about dynamite? Yes? It's an explosive, okay. And when you talk about dynamite, is it used in both ways? As good as well as in bad ways? How defense? Okay, for defense, well, then it is good. But if you're attacking, then it is wrong. So we need dynamite also. Otherwise, also, where else is dynamite used? Mining. Mining, you have the roads also. You're building the roads. So, you know, like, yeah, to the hilly areas and all to make it accessible, isn't it? Right? Now, who discovered dynamite? Have you heard of the Nobel Peace Prize? Nobel Prize, have you heard about it? Nobel Prize, have you heard about it? Yes. What is it meant for? We have prizes which are given in various fields.